Hello, in the previous video of the chapter What is Democracy? Why Democracy? We have discussed the case study of Pakistan, and in the case study of Pakistan we have discussed a feature that in a democracy major decisions must be taken by those leaders which are elected by the people. So elected leaders must take major policy decisions is one of the feature of democracy. In that feature, or with the help of that feature, we came to the conclusion that under Parvez Musharraf Pakistan was non-democratic because the major decisions were taken by Parvez Musharraf and he was not elected by the people. He was a military ruler. So in this class, in this lecture, we are again going to discuss a feature of democracy, and with the help of this feature we would discuss the case study of China and Mexico, and we will try to prove whether China can be called a democratic country and whether Mexico can be called a democratic country. First, let us discuss this feature and then we will take up the case study of China and Mexico. The feature is free and fair electoral competition. We know that in a democracy, rulers must be the representatives of the people. It means that people must elect their rulers in elections. And election must be conducted in a free and fair manner. Election in a democracy must be conducted in a free and fair manner. Now we will discuss these two terms first. What is free election and what is a fair election? Free election is one where every person has equal right to vote. When all the people, they have equal right to vote, such an election is called a free election. So when the question comes about free and fair elections, we have to answer, we have to explain these two terms, free elections and fair elections. So free election is one where every person has an equal right to vote and people can vote without any fear. This is free elections. So in a free elections, people can cast their vote without fear and people are allowed to cast their vote. They have the right to do so. A fair election is one in which those persons who are currently in power, they have a fair chance of losing the elections. A fair chance of losing the election means that in the elections, those political parties who are ruling the country, they have a fair chance of losing the elections. So in a fair election, voters, they can cast their vote without any fear, without any threat. And in a fair elections, those persons who are in power, they have a fair chance of losing. Means there is a fear in the minds of the ruling party and the elected representatives that if they are not working in a proper way, they can lose the elections. So with this, with the help of this feature, we will try to prove whether China was democracy or is democratic, or Mexico is democratic. So let us discuss with China first. Now in China, elections are conducted regularly every after 5 years. So every after 5 years, there is regular elections. And the elections are conducted in a country for the selection of a parliament. And the selection of the parliament is, the parliament is referred to as the National People's Congress. The parliament is referred to as the National People Congress. And in order to elect the National People's Congress, elections are conducted every 5 years. The National People's Congress has the power to appoint the president of the country. Means the president of the country will be appointed by the National People Congress, that is the parliament of China. Now some members in the country are elected by the army, and there are about 3,000 members in all which are elected by the army in the government. Now, if anybody wants to conduct election in China, if any political party wants to conduct election in China, that political party has to be the affiliates of the Chinese Communist Party. Affiliates of Chinese Communist Party means that any political party who want to contest an election in China has to take the approval of Chinese Communist Party. They have to take permission from the Chinese Communist Party. Now in China, the government is always formed by the Communist Party of China. So the government is formed by the Communist Party of China. And we can say that Communist Party of China does not has the fear in the mind of losing the elections. They know that the elections in China will always be won by the Chinese Communist Party, and the Chinese Communist Party will be forming the government. So this feature of democracy, that is free and fair elections, electoral competition, is not followed in China. So we can say that China is not democratic on the basis of this feature. Now let us take the case study of Mexico. Mexico, it gained independence in 1930, and since its independence in 1930, Mexico holds election every after 6 years to elect its president. It means after the independence of the country in 1930, Mexico holds election every after 6 years in order to elect the president of the country. Now this country, Mexico, is never under a military rule or a dictator's rule. It is not under the military rule, or it is not under the
dictators rule. It means the government is elected by the process of elections. Now, after 2000, every election was won by the party that is known as PRI. After 2000, every time the election is won by PRI, a political party, refers to as PRI. And the full form of PRI is Institutional Revolutionary Party. PRI is a Institutional Revolutionary Party. The Institutional Revolutionary Party wins election every time after 2000. It means this party is also not having a fear in his mind to lose the elections. Now, why it is so? In Mexico, PRI uses many dirty tricks in order to win the elections. Dirty tricks here means that PRI is using different wrong ways to win the elections. All the government officers, teachers, they force the parents to vote for the PRI. That is, the government officials, they work in such a way that people vote to PRI, and the teachers, they also force the parents to vote for the political party, the PRI. Sometimes what happens that the polling booths is shifted from one place to another place so that the people, they do not reach there to cast their vote. Now children, what are polling booths? Polling booths are the places where people go to cast their votes. You must have seen that when your parents, they go to cast their vote, they go to a nearby school, the places is fixed, or a nearby building, official building, which is fixed by the election commission. So that is a polling booth. In simple language, you can say polling booths are the places where elections are held. So what happens that sometimes the polling booths are shifted from one place to another place. This is also a trick to win the elections. This is done so that the people, they do not reach to cast the vote, those places where people are not in favor of the government. Now, media, they are also ignoring the activities of the opposition parties. What the media is doing, media is also helping the government in order to win the elections. So media is always working in favor of the ruling party, that is the PRI. And media is against the opposition party. It means media never takes the news of opposition parties, and it only criticizes the works of the opposition parties. So media is also not working in a fair manner. It is also not working in a balanced manner. Media is used by the government to win the elections. And the candidates of the political party, that is the PRI, it spends large amount of money to win the elections. In the election campaign, large amount of money is spent by the candidates of the political party to win the elections. So when you take the case of PRI, you also come to the conclusion that Mexico is not democratic. Why? Because after 2000, a single political party is winning the election. That was not wrong. But in order to win the elections,
PRI is using various faulty ways, various wrong methods to win the elections. Once you can recall those wrong methods. What are these wrong methods? The government officials, they are working in favor of the government. The parents, the teachers, they are forcing the parents to cast their vote. Election booths are the polling booths, they are shifted from one place to another place in the last minutes. Media, they are also working in favor of the ruling party, that is the PRI. And at the same time, large amount of money is spent by PRI and the leaders of PRI to win the elections. So here also free and fair elections are not conducted. So you can say Mexico is also non-democratic. Okay, now should we consider this country as democratic country? So what will our answer? Our answer is no. A democracy must be based on free and fair elections. Why? Because those persons who are in power, they must have the fair chance of losing the elections. They must be having a fear in the mind that they can lose the elections. In both the cases, in the case of Mexico and the case of China, the Communist Party of China do not have the fear that they will lose the elections. Similarly, PRI is also not having a fear that they will lose the elections because they use many dirty tricks to win the elections. So both these countries cannot be called as democratic countries. So this is all about the lecture, the feature, free and fair elections, and the two countries case studies we have done. And we have tried to prove whether the countries are the democratic or non-democratic country. Thank you. See you in the next lecture. And in that also we'll do one of the features of democracy.